Regular mammograms can be effective in detecting breast cancer, but for women with dense breast tissue, more advanced technology might be needed to find and diagnose abnormalities. And to learn more, we welcome Dr. Bhavika Patel, Chair of Radiology Research at Mayo Clinic Arizona. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Define dense breast tissue.
Dense breast tissue is pretty much the fibrous elements that make up a woman's breast. It's only seen on imaging, so it's a way for a radiologist to grade what their breast tissue looks like. And ultimately, dense breast tissue is very normal. 50% of women have dense breast tissue.
Okay, but it also means a higher risk of breast cancer, true?
True. So most recently, the federal legislation has required and made a reporting that as a woman, if you have dense breast tissue, you will be notified that you have dense breast tissue. And so women who get standard mammograms will now be receiving a notification in their report. So on their mammogram report, it will state that they have dense breast tissue. What does that mean for the woman? Well, that means that you're part of 50% of women, so one in two women that have dense breast tissue. And the reason we are informing women of this is twofold. So just like you mentioned, number one, having dense breast tissue does increase your risk of developing breast cancer. And number two, it makes it harder for us as imagers to find the breast cancer.
And then comes the supplemental imaging, this newfangled enhanced mammography. What are we talking about? How does it work?
Yes. So for women that have dense breast tissue, where they have many options. First, we recommend that the woman speak with their provider about different imaging technologies. So this is what you're referring to. Contrast-enhanced mammography is one option that women could potentially talk about. But ultimately, the point from the dense breast legislation is for women to know that they have dense breast tissue and talk to their providers about different options in the screening setting. So we think about various opportunities for women. Things like magnetic resonance imaging is one, MRI. Another is ultrasound imaging. Another is standard digital mammography with tomosynthesis. So we would want to make sure that women get that. And then we also think about molecular breast imaging. So these are all different technologies that are available for women. Our team at Mayo Clinic has been doing some study and research as it relates to contrast-enhanced mammography.
Yes, and that, it sounds as though you might have a mammography that says negative, but you go through this supplemental screening, or is it a screening or a diagnostic tool or both?
Yes, good question. So ultimately, Ted, we have used contrast-enhanced mammography in the diagnostic setting for at least 5 years in Arizona now. And ultimately, we're using it for problem-solving technology. So we have seen it be very effective in women that are newly diagnosed with breast cancer. We've seen it be very helpful in women for problem-solving tools or other actual problems that they come in with. So that's in the diagnostic setting. Because we have had such good use cases of it in our diagnostic setting, our team at Mayo Clinic decided, let's study this in the screening setting. So we did a small research trial. We incorporated women that had negative standard mammograms. So these were women that were coming in annually for their screening and they had a negative mammogram. We invited them to come back within 12 months of their negative mammogram for an additional contrast enhanced study. In that study, we had 461 patients that came in, and we found 14 additional cancers that were not seen with standard imaging.
Wow.
So we were very excited about the results in the sense that, is this another tool in our tool belt to help women that may not be getting supplemental imaging with other technologies?
Is it a tool in the toolbox that Medicare, that insurance will cover?
That is a great question, and that is one that we need to. So our team and other teams across the nation are doing studies to sort out, number one, does it work? In what patients does it work in? And how do we get it reimbursed? So currently it is not FDA approved for screening. It is for diagnostic use. The more studies that come out with larger patient populations showing the same benefit or added value, the more hopeful we are that this technology would potentially be approved and for insurance purposes in the screening setting as well.
Yeah, we got to get going here, but real quickly, are you encouraged by this?
incredibly encouraged. Number one, it is great news for women that we are being required to inform women of breast density. So if nothing else, learn about your breast density, make sure you advocate for yourself, and sort out what sort of different imaging technologies are available for you.
All right. Very encouraging news.
Exciting times.
Doctor, good to have you here. Thanks for sharing that information. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.